Welcome to this TraiNDE UT tutorial. This video shows an example of an exercise workflow, calibration, sensitivity and inspection. Let's illustrate the workflow with the exercise Plate 01. This exercise includes a V1 block, a step block with flat bottom holes and the plate to inspect. One longitudinal waves dual element transducer is available. The exercise starts with the V1 block in order to begin with the calibration of the probe and the relevant dummy probe. When you place the dummy probe on the V1 block, you can observe that the signal remains flat and red. You have to change the probe type from PE to SE. Then the signal becomes green. Let's set 48 dB of gain to observe the echoes. The section view helps to locate the dummy probe on the block and to position it in the 100 mm deep zone. To calibrate the velocity, let's activate gate A. The left tip of the gate allows you to move it horizontally, the right tip to resize it, and the center to move it vertically. Set up the gate A to trigger the first bottom echo. Activate the gate B and set it up to trigger the repetition bottom echo. You can double-click on SPB, the gate B sound path monitoring, to switch it to SPAB, the sound path between gate A and gate B. Let's now change the velocity in order to get SPAB at 100 mm. You can initialize it with the standard velocity, 5920 m/s. SPAB measures 100.2 mm. By clicking the plus and minus buttons, you refine the velocity until SPAB steadily measures 100 mm. To calibrate the zero, which is the sound path inside the wedge of the probe, let's deactivate gate B. You have to find the value of the zero in order to get SPA at 100 mm. By clicking the plus and minus buttons, you refine the zero until SPA steadily measures 100 mm. You can refine the decimal values with the calculator. You can also check your settings by positioning the dummy probe in the 91 mm deep zone. As you see, gate A measures 91 mm. You can save your calibration setup in the memory menu if you want to reload it in the future. Let's switch the component to the step block in order to create the sensitivity curve of the probe. Reopening the section view will help you locate your dummy probe on the block. The step block has a minimum depth of 60 mm, so let's change the time base to 80 mm. Let's change gate A to fit the screen width. When you scan the probe along the block, you can see the red dot in the section view that represents the triggering of gate A, matching the bottom face. Let's change the gain to 36 dB. The block has one flat bottom hole per step. Let's display them and position the dummy probe on the deepest one. The echo of the flat bottom hole appears a few millimeters ahead of the bottom echo. The flat bottom hole of the thinnest step can hardly be seen since it is located in the dead zone. Then, you will create the sensitivity curve for the second flat bottom hole. You can set the gain in order to set this echo at 80% by using the Auto 80% option. Let's enter the TGC DAC menu. Click Setup to create the sensitivity curve. To display the DAC measures at the top, you replace AMPB by AMPDAC and SPAB by SPDAC. You then move the probe above the second flat bottom hole to maximize the amplitude of its echo. You position the gate on the echo and press Add a point. Then, move to the probe above the third flat bottom hole and maximize its echo. Adjust the gate and click Add a point. Number of points has increased. add the four other points. Your sensitivity curve is built and you can validate it by clicking on Back. You can save the sensitivity curve by clicking Save if you want to reload it in the future. Let's display the TGC curve by switching Activated from Off to TGC or DAC, depending on your habit. Let's disable the Flow Display option and switch the component to the plate. The plate is 23mm thick, so you can change the time base to 30mm and the depth to 23mm. Let's also display the legs and decrease the gain by 6 dB. You are now ready to inspect the plate. Thank you for watching this video. If you need further information, please visit our website traindee.xtend.com or contact us at traindee@xtend.com.